I actually did my undergraduate degree in engineering, and I was following the footsteps of my father. And about, you know, 3 years into engineering, I felt like I needed to have a little bit more impact on people. I applied for a combined MD-PhD program in biomedical engineering and medicine, and then I decided to just focus on medicine, which actually is what brought me to radiology. I'm a musculoskeletal radiologist, so musculoskeletal radiology is basically dealing with bones, muscles, sports injuries, things like that. So I've been in that role of leading our fellows for quite some time, and it's been one of the most rewarding aspects of my job, you know, to be able to guide the next generation of musculoskeletal radiologists as they go out into practice. They're not considered trainees in our program. We really consider them colleagues. We work side by side with them, and we learn from them just as much as they learn from us. And that's one of the most rewarding things for me, is I'm constantly learning new things that they're asking me questions, and I'm having to go and increase my own knowledge so that I can be a better teacher to them. What's interesting is that our fellows and our residents who come here, amazingly, many of them end up staying here. It's what I like to call a metropolis without the headaches of a large city. It takes 10 minutes to get from, you know, the suburbs to the city. You know, you can live anywhere. The housing is extremely affordable, even for a trainee. I think I was very fortunate to choose radiology, to become a musculoskeletal radiologist, and to end up at the Cleveland Clinic. I'm doing all the things that I love, which is, you know, really doing world-class, you know, clinical care, you know, getting to be around really smart people. That's really the most attractive thing for me, is to get to work with not just great radiologists, but great clinicians and great scientists.